So this is Scott. So I have this fun idea. So Scott's going to take over while I'm on stage because I fear it ever goes off stage. So there's no, like, fun backstage antics. But something I've been thinking about a lot is the multiple layers of reality of the show. You know, because sometimes Pierre sees what's going on. Sometimes he doesn't. Sometimes actors walk through spaces that some actors can see and others can't. There's, like, these multiple portals of reality. Sometimes the audience is there, sometimes they're not. And I thought that Scott here could narrate Pierre's inner journey when he's not singing. Like, what's Pierre thinking during the opera?
Yeah.
What's Pierre thinking during Natasha and Anatole? What's he thinking during Sony Alone?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe we have different thoughts.
We probably do.
That's what Scott's going to do. And what's the cool thing?
The cool thing is I think I still have the login info for this, so I'm going to do it on my phone up in my dressing room, listening along to the show.
On his own phone?
Oh, my God.
This means you're not going to be able to do your crossword as much.
Well, when you're singing, I'll be doing it.
Oh, my God. There's a really hard one. Well, it's places, so I got to go get into my place. I don't actually know why I go in places, because everyone else has to do the pierogies, and I don't. So I don't actually have to be there at the same time as everyone. Look, there's all these people again. this is Coop. He checks my mic to make sure there's no beard hairs in it.
Yeah, so let's check that now.
Oh, yeah.
Nice.
Thanks. This is where I just stand backstage. Emma stands with me with some water. Sometimes Lucas comes and gives me a hug.
Like this time.
Oh! Have a good show!
Me
too. And this is the fun part where Nick is hanging out. And Nick is just wearing like a black t-shirt, like a totally modern person playing guitar.
I don't want to ruffle up my seat jacket.
Because he puts on the seat jacket at the last possible second. So,
Hi, Nick.
Hi.
Are you filming it?
Yes.
Emma's holding the camera now, and now I have an accordion on. Sometimes I practice this part. Well, there's a chord here. I never know what to play. So it is the chord. One wants it to play.
Stage, Scott's take, chapter one. I had to race up here to get up to my dressing room after watching the first two numbers, and I had some technical issues with the sound on my phone. So here we go. I'm thinking, don't screw up the accordion notes. You got like 10 seconds to strap on the accordion, and once you start playing, I do start to think about the characters, and I'm watching my old friend Maria, and one of my favorite things to do is play as a musician in a pit and support my fellow cast members with the accordion and play in a band. My favorite example of that is in the Bolkonsky number, where old Bolkonsky's freaking out. A big part of my journey as Pierre is watching not only my friends, like Pierre's friends, but also like Scott's friends on stage and these characters that are going through what they're going through. I just think it's a remarkable thing. One of the more heartbreaking moments to watch, because I just love Kelsey Bell and Nick Belton, but it's just this old man. So anyway, one big part of my process as Scott and hence as Pierre is sitting in the pit and watching my friends and the world around him as it plays out. And so a lot of my thought process is, look, Pierre may not in real life be witnessing these events, but that doesn't mean that these characters like Andre in No One Else isn't on Pierre's mind either. So he gets to look at him and think of his friend. I just love what Rachel has set up as that kind of convention, and it allowed me to play with my own internal arc in point, it's Pierre's job to accompany the, or play in the band as a tambourine player, playing on the offbeat, and it's a lot of fun, but it's also hard when Nick Belton is making you laugh, and... Ah, I love it! Or Matias, our old music director, used to do this with his hand. Natasha's singing about Andre, and not only do I love watching my friends sing the song or watch the light bulbs come down, but I also think Pierre could be thinking about Andre too. He misses his friend. He's away at war, and he's lost it. And I think that's a really good word for it, reverie. To get lost in a reverie, in like a memory. And I think that not only is Pierre a searcher, but he's also somebody that gets lost in his own mind a lot. And right now, and I love this part. I love playing this part on the accordion. All of your friends are at the opera, and it's all about like not screwing up the accordion part again. It's a joy to play. But you're also watching Dolokhov swagger through the opera, and your wife on his tail. That sucks. You're not, again, Pierre's not watching this, but doesn't mean that's not on his mind, these two canoodlers. Okay, Dave just finished singing Dust and Ashes. Just to catch you up really quick. During opera part two, when the opera singers are singing, Pierre's playing drums. And that's just fun. A lot of fun. And opera part three, he sees Andre, a representation of Andre at war. That's scary. The moment after the opera, Pierre dives headfirst into his books, and we have a prop book that is all in Russian. It's in Cyrillic, and I don't read Cyrillic, so I like to imagine that I'm reading a lot of philosophy, a lot of poetry. I actually write in the book a lot, too, my own thoughts. And in those moments of studying, I don't think that Pierre is at the depths of his depression yet. He's drinking and drinking and drinking, and he's, you know, lost in reverie about his friend at war and all these philosophical questions that he has, but he's not quite there yet. He hasn't really peaked yet. All right, this is charming. I'll let Dave talk about when he's actually singing, but when we come back down from the duel and Dust and Ashes, we meet Pierre at his depths of depression. Like, he just asked God for help, and he received no answer, so charming is depressing. So what does Pierre do in the depths of depression while his wife dances around the stage? He turns back to his old friend, the bottle, and, well, books. Books in the bottle. And sulks. Fun little fact for me, at least. I like to think that Pierre actually is in the ball because the party is actually at his house. I like to think of him as being in, like, the next room. So these people that are dancing around him while he's reading is really kind of annoying. That about covers it for Act 1. The ball's wrapping up. We do the wine glass moment, and that's particularly haunting to be a part of. But intermission's coming. So is Dave. We'll see you at Act 2.